Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over 5 things to avoid when using Microsoft Excel. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. Our first mistake to avoid is setting up your data if you are going to use a pivot table. In this case, I have some data for how much I've spent by month per category. So right here, I have the categories of clothes, food, and utility, and then I have data by month over here. But the problem is this becomes very difficult to create a pivot table with because the pivot table usually wants to do some sums when the table is created. So a better way to set this table up and to get similar results would be to not separate out each one of these months here. So over here, I'm going to copy these categories and paste them over here for the 6 months that I have. And instead of putting the month across the top, I'm just going to put a date of 1-1 for these, 2-1 for these, and so on to the end of my sheet. And then next, I'm just going to copy these values over here. These are my January values, February, and so on. So this is the way I should have been doing data entry all along. Now, if I need to get this result out just like it is over here, I'm going to highlight my data here, go up to Insert, go over to Pivot Table, and then down here, I'm going to select Existing Worksheet, click this up arrow, and just put my data right here in N2. Click this button and say OK. And now when I go to build my pivot table, I'm going to want the category down here for my rows. I'm going to select the date and drag the months up here into my columns. Select the down arrow on date and say remove field. And take the amounts and just put a sum right here. And then I'm going to close this. And you can see that the data that I'm getting here in my pivot table is the same data that I'm getting over here. And I can also have my grand totals. Our second tip for today is if you are not using a pivot table, it is not a good idea to really put your data with a comma separating two of the fields. So in this case, we have an amount that was spent in what months? January and March. And then in this case, we have another amount that was spent in February and April. This is not a very user-friendly way to read your data. In this case, it might be better to put your data in a matrix. So let's start here with January, February, March. If we highlight those, we can drag those over and use the autofill for the rest of the months. So in January here, we spent $500, same in March. And in this case, we spent $750 in both February and April, $600 in January and May, and so on. And if we put the numbers in a matrix like this, we can just highlight the numbers and go to Home and go to Conditional Formatting. And we can highlight our cells that are greater than, let's say, 0 and say OK. This is a more user-friendly way to read the data that you're trying to get across. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. The next thing to avoid is bringing in anything you want to calculate in the form of text. Now, this sometimes happens when you import data from a foreign source. Sometimes dates and numbers come in as text instead of the date or number you want it to be. In this case, that's exactly what's happened. If I highlight my 3 dates right here and I go up to Home, I can see that they've come in as text. So if I change the format there to be date and I go back to Excel and I go into this cell and I just do a formula on this for a date. So I would say equals this date plus 1 and hit enter. I can see that I'm having an issue because Excel is still not calculating my formula. So let's click back there and hit delete. When I click an A2, I get a warning right here. If I click the down arrow, I can convert this to either the 1900s or the 2000s. Let's convert it to the 2000s. Now if I click in B2, I can do equals this plus 1 and hit enter. And I can see now Excel is recognizing this as a date. So if I highlight these three numbers right here and I go up to home and I go down to number, I can see that I'm still getting an error on some of these. They are left aligned. They're not being right aligned. So it doesn't really look like that this is being formatted as a number. If I want to fix that and I want these all to be right aligned and formatted as a number, here's one little quick tip you can do. You can do equals this cell times one and hit enter. And then I can just copy my formula down and I can now see that I have a number that I can work with. Some versions of Excel can automatically read text fields as numbers, but some cannot. So this is a good workaround when you're in the situation where it cannot. Our fourth tip for today is formatting a table. So if you've ever been in this scenario before where you highlight a column and you want the formatting that you put in this column to keep continuing. So I highlight this column and I go to home and let's say I make this currency and I also make the background yellow. That looks okay, but if I keep scrolling down, I can see that I have millions of rows that I've formatted as yellow. And that's taking up extra memory in Excel. So I'm going to hit Control Z on both of those. And let's take up a little less memory by highlighting this range right here and going to Insert and go to Table. And it says, where's the data for your table? I'm just going to take the default selection and say, okay. Now, if I select this column, I can go up to Home and I can highlight the back of that and I can set this to currency. And now when I add new rows, so let's say I have a food expense for 7-1 for 300. That's going into a row that I already had in my table. But what if I click outside my table right here and I go to utilities and I also do 7-1 and I do 400. I can see that this has added a new row to my table. Let's do one more so you can see the alternating blue background. If I do close and I do 7-1, and let's just say that was 200, you can see now this is the blue background and this keeps adding rows to my table, copying the format that I've already done. And you can see that these cells here don't have that format in it and is not taking up extra space inside of your Excel workbook. And for our final tip, let's talk about merging cells. Have you ever done this before? Where you highlight a header and you go up to home and you hit this nice button here that merges and centers your data. Let's do that for each one of these years. It looks a little nice because it's centered, but have you ever gone back and just highlighted these columns because you wanted a total? And then you realize it highlights everything because you've hit a merged cell and you can't really total up everything. So here is a little workaround. To bypass that, I'm going to hit Control Z three times so that my merge and centered formatting is taken off. You can see this is back on this cell. And now I'm going to highlight these two cells and right click and go to Format Cells. And under Alignment, under Horizontal, I'm going to go to Center Across Selection and say OK. And then I'm just going to right click and go to Format Cells again, go to Alignment, under Horizontal, and go to Center Across Selection again. And then I'm going to do that one more time right here. And now when I highlight this column, you can see the numbers down here where I can sum up and get a min or a max and use this quick toolbar down here to give me some totals. So instead of using this button here that merges your actual cells, you really only need to highlight, right click, go to Format Cells, and use the Center Across Selection Alignment. So hopefully that gives you a few tips on how to be a little more productive inside of Microsoft Excel. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.